a lot of people entering college don't know much about geography. People don't come in thinking, I want to be a geographer. What I tend to tell my students is, I hope you leave with more questions than answers, because you should always be questioning what you observe, what you read about, and what you hear. Well, there are several reasons why students should study geography at Cal State Northridge. Students will not only learn about the world around them, but they will also learn valuable technical skills as well as written and oral communication skills. The students can be part of the standard program or the GIS option, and there is a lot of overlap between these programs. Within the standard option, students can either have a human cultural emphasis or a physical environmental emphasis, or some combination of the two. In the GIS option, there's a more technically based major, but students will also have the opportunity and requirement to do some studies in environmental and or human cultural geography.
One fascinating part of geography is the use and development of Geographical Information Systems, or GIS, using computer technologies to collect, store, manipulate, analyze, and visualize spatial data.
Not many students get jobs as a geographer per se, right? Many of our students find work in state and national parks, government agencies, consulting firms, private corporations. Crime mapping is also a big area where students will work for police departments mapping out crimes.
We do an exercise called Finding the Hollywood Arsonist. And what students do in my class is to map the criminal behavior around Hollywood, and we use a reasonably simple algorithm to predict where did this fellow live. I frequently tell people who I meet that say, what does a geographer do? I ask them, well, have you ever seen a McDonald's go out of business? And occasionally you will, but it's really quite rare. And the reason is because McDonald's has a really crack staff of geographers that do something called retail site location.
We have a vibrant and expanding internship program. We will train you and get you a job, and you will learn valuable skills that will help you in your future.
Right now we have students who are interning in the United States Forest Service, the Los Angeles Department of Water and Power, the Coastal Commission, the U.S. Geological Survey, and so on. And you have to bear in mind that students in physical geography have a very integrative approach to the discipline. They are comfortable working out of doors. So, for example, if you ask them to complete a survey on a river or to actually get into a river and measure discharge, they're comfortable doing this and then bringing the data back to the office and putting it together.
I was actually a business major as an undergrad, and I realized I wasn't satisfied with what I was doing. My passions were teaching and traveling, so geography seemed like a logical major for me to get into.
I had already had 2 degrees. And I was just finishing up an extra class, and I had a class by a really brilliant lecturer, and a light bulb came on, and I realized I had been studying the wrong thing. My dissertation that I had in my head already was about why certain cities are musically innovative, like Seattle with the grunge rock, why Memphis for rock and roll, why New Orleans for jazz. And I was trying to do it in maybe history or sociology or something, but it turns out that geography was a far better medium for me to ask the kind of questions that I wanted to ask.
I think I'm like a lot of other people. It was hidden inside me and I didn't know it. One day I happened to walk into just the right geography class. The professor was talking about rivers, hill slopes, and how water flows, and all the lights went on. So I like to say that I actually took my hobby and I made it my profession.